Michaela. I'm a member of our Sensor Fusion DevKit team. Our Atlas DevKit has a wide variety of purposes, such as collecting and crowdsourcing data. We use it in-house for the testing and deployment of our own technology and products, and our customers can use it as a reference design for their own testing. The first thing you need to be able to run our localization software is input from the various sensors on the kit. This is the LiDAR, which sends laser packets to the device running the compute. This is the IMU, and this is the GPS, which are used to calculate the car's position. We also have a camera on the kit, which is used for visualization purposes. The next thing is the device, which is actually running the stack. We can use a computer board such as an Odroid, which would actually be inside of this kit here and connected to the LiDAR through a switch, or we can use a laptop. I'll show you how the hardware is mapped to the software through a hardware config. Our Atlas DevKit is sensor agnostic, which means we can use any type of LiDAR or IMU or GPS. And the way we transmit the information about those sensors to the stack is through a config. So here we have the type of LiDAR, the number of lasers, the bore sighting in between the LiDAR and the IMU, and the network interface, which could be Ethernet or USB. We use an Ethernet. We also have information about the other sensors, such as the IMU and the GPS. Next, you need a network connection, and you can use anything that will let you connect the compute device to the internet, such as a mobile phone or a Wi-Fi hotspot. And finally, you need power. We use a simple cigarette lighter, which allows us to connect the Atlas DevKit to any type of car. To mount the Atlas, you need two people, one to hold the Atlas and the other person to align the first mounting bracket and screw. So I've already done that for you. This here is the mounting bracket. It fits over any universal roof rack, which fits on any car. So after you've aligned the Atlas with the mounting bracket, you screw in all four screws on each side. And this is just to secure it tightly so it doesn't move. After you finish securing the Atlas to the roof rack, all that's left to do is attaching the two Ethernet cords to the DevKit, and these connect the Atlas DevKit to the compute device and the HMI laptop, and the device is ready to use. Now that we've mounted the DevKit, we're ready to attach the Atlas DevKit to our laptop. So there's only three connections needed. We have an Ethernet, which connects to the compute laptop. Another Ethernet, which connects to the laptop where we're running the HMI, which is our visualization. And finally, a USB, which has the sensor stream from the IMU. All that's left is plugging in the Atlas DevKit, which is now powered on and ready to go.